In this lesson, as a curiosity, I will show you how you can create one and the same part in three different ways, using three different modules. And at the beginning, we will create a part in the part design module. It will be a simple part. Select Create New and create a new sketch on the XY plane. Select Drawing a Rectangle. Then select the horizontal dimension. Select this edge and here enter 100 mm. Then select vertical dimension. Select this edge and here enter 60 mm and click OK. Close the sketch and on the basis of this sketch add a 15 mm extrusion. Then select this face. Select Create a new sketch. And on this face draw a rectangle with dimension 60 by 40 mm. And also define the position of this rectangle relative to this point. Close the sketch and add a pocket at a depth of 5 mm. Select this face again. Select Create a new sketch. Draw a circle with a diameter of 10 mm. And add dimensions. To specify the position of this point. Here 15 mm. And here 30 mm. Click Close and on the basis of this circle add a pocket. And here select Through All. And we have a simple part. Let's add the rounding of the corner of this pocket. Switch to the wireframe view. Then select the Fillet command. And select the edges to be rounded. And define a radius of 5 mm. And click OK. Switch back to the as-is view. And this is how we created such a solid. And now let's create the same solid in another module. Create a new project. Switch to the part module. And now in the part module let's create such a solid. And in the part module we work in such a way that we create solids on the basis of simple shapes. And on the basis of Boolean operations. That is, for example, on the basis of the operation of adding and subtracting two solids from each other. And let's start by creating a cuboid. Select this icon to create a cube. Now switch to the Model tab. And define the dimensions of this cube. Length 100 mm, width 60 mm, and height 15 mm. So the same dimensions as this cuboid. Okay. Then create another cube. And now define the dimensions of this cube. Such as the dimensions of this rectangle. 60 mm by 40 mm. 60 mm by 40 mm. And here we had a pocket depth of 5 mm. So here, as the height of this rectangle, enter 5 mm. And now we have to define the appropriate position of this cube. And here expand the placement tab, position. And in the x-axis enter 30 mm and in the y-axis 10 mm. And in the z-axis also 10 mm. And now we have to subtract this second solid from the first solid. Select the first solid and with the control key select the second solid. And select the operation of subtracting one solid from the other. And we have something like this. And now let's create a cylinder. A cylinder with a diameter of 10 mm, that is a radius of 5 mm, a height of 15 mm. And the position of the cylinder in the x-axis 15 mm, in the y-axis 30 mm. And similarly, as in the previous case, here first select a larger solid, then a smaller one. So first select the solid from which you will subtract the next selected solid. Select the cut operation. And this is how we created something like this. And now switch to the wireframe view and add the rounding of the edges of the pocket. Select the edges of the pocket with the control key. Select the fillet command and add a radius of 5 mm and click OK. Switch back to the as-is view and we have the same solid that we created in the part design module. In the part design module, we worked on sketches, so here we worked on basic shapes and on Boolean operations. And now I will show you one more way to create such a solid. Let's create another project, this time select the draft module. And in the draft module select the XY plane. Set the top view. And now let's draw a rectangle. We can draw a rectangle in such a way that first we draw any rectangle and now we define its position. I would like the position of this rectangle to be at the origin of the coordinate systems. X0, Y0. And now when it comes to the dimensions of this rectangle, we define them here. Here 60, here 100. And we have created the first rectangle. And now let's create another rectangle. Select draw a rectangle. And when drawing a rectangle, we can also define the coordinate vertices of the rectangle. And here the first vertex will be in the coordinate x30, y10. Click enter point to confirm it. And as a coordinate of the second vertex, enter here 60, and here 40. Because, as you can see, we define here the incremental coordinates. We have delta x and delta y here. And click enter point. And we have created a second rectangle. It's still a flat drawing. Let's create a circle. And a circle, like a rectangle, can be drawn in such a way that we indicate two points of the circle here in the drawing. Or we just enter the coordinates of these points. And at the beginning enter the coordinate center of the circle. And here, as x, enter 15, as y, 30. Click enter point. And then define the radius and radius of 5 mm. And click enter. And okay, we have created the initial drawing. It's a flat drawing. Turn off the grid visibility. And now, to create a 3D model based on this geometry, you need to switch to the part module. And based on these geometries, we can add solids. Select the first rectangle. Select the extrude. And here add an extrusion of 15 mm. Then select the second rectangle. And here add an extrusion of 5 mm. And select the circle. And add an extrusion of 15 mm. Now we have to move the second rectangle by 10 mm up. Expand the placement position tab here. And enter 10 mm here. And just like in the case of creating this 3D model in the part module, we cut one solid from the other. We have to do the same in this case. Select the first cuboid. With the control key, select the second cuboid. And select the cut operation to cut one solid from the other. And now select this solid. Select the second solid. And select the cut operation. And let's add roundings in the pocket. Switch to the wireframe view. With the control key, select four edges. And select the fillet command. Enter 5 mm as the rounding radius. And click OK. Switch to the as-is view. And this is how we created this solid. We created this part in three different ways using three different modules. The first way was to create this part using a 2D sketch and solid operations in the part design module. The second way was to create basic shapes and then cut one solid from the other in the part module. And I think it can be useful in some cases. And the third way was to create flat geometries in the draft module, and then add extrusions in the part module and cut one solid from the other. The third way required the most steps. It is worth treating as a curiosity, not as a main way to create 3D solids. And that's all for today. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to this channel.